Hey Saber fans, so I got quite a long video for you today. So it's going to be my first real long tutorial video. A lot of people do them. I figure I might as well do one with the Verso. So the Verso is a new soundboard from KR Sabers for those of you who are unfamiliar with it. It is a very small, compact, feature-rich board. And this is brand new from KR Sabers. So anybody that's in the loop will know that whenever I first power this up, it's going to re-update the firmware pretty much. Like crystal core initiating, something like that. Anyways, I'm going to be installing this into a SaberForge ASP. This is a repair for a client, and he has been very patient with me and I appreciate it. So I'm going to show him my appreciation by upgrading from the Crystal Shard version 4 to the Verso. Because I've installed one of these already, and it's a fantastic board. It's really great. Color changing on the fly. You get one font right now. It's going to be seeing a lot of firmware updates in the future, which I'm highly, highly excited about. A few of the things I have with me. I have my phone for music. I have the charger for my phone and the camera. Have handy-dandy water. Definitely need something like that if you're going to be doing a tutorial video. The hilt. Now this is a basic SaberForge. This is what I recommend anybody start off on with if they're going to get into this as a hobby for installing, because it's so simple. You have a lot of options you can do to a SaberForge hilt other than just the basic install. But for this, I'm going to do basic, because KR Sabers is one of the people who likes to get people into this. I would like to see more people get into it as well, but it does take a great deal of patience, and it does take a great deal of thought. You cannot go into this thinking that it's going to be easy. Path of any Jedi is not an easy one, correct? Now, first thing you want to do is you want to get your soldering iron set up. Me, I have one that I got off Amazon. What is it? Siwon? The one I'm using. It's got a temperature control gauge, it's ESD safe, about 25 bucks maybe, and I have it set at 350 right now. So usually around the 350 range goes good. I'm going to be installing this with NeoPixel, removable battery, recharge port, momentary switch, yada yada yada. I'll go over the components, and after I go over the components, going to start some Star Wars music, and we're just going to go through it. I'll try to give some tips along the way. This is not scripted. It's just doing it for the community and having fun while doing it. That's what it's all about. I've done a lot of videos regarding my install work. This already feels a little different for me, so bear with me. So we have a SaberForge scratch indent here with one of these millions and millions of pommels that they shipped out. Put a little bit of mesh in there to protect against touching the speaker. A little bit of E6000 around the edge and the mesh. Good to go. Now with this hilt comes a part up here. So this is where a great deal of thinking is going to come into it. So me seeing this, I know that this is going to be the NeoPixel retention. So, that gives me an option. Do I want to wire to the board or from the board? What I mean by that is, do I want to solder all my wires to the board and lead it up to the components? I don't think I want to, just because it's going to be a lot harder to sink these into place. I think it'll be a lot easier to solder from the components up here going down into the board. It'll be a lot easier to secure these, and honestly, this board is so compact and it requires so little wiring, it's really not going to look much better if I solder from the board to the components. That's really the only advantage from going to the board to the components, is that it will help your board look cleaner in certain chassis setups. Like, let's say I'm wiring a KR Sabers Hero and I want there to be virtually no visible wires on the board. The chassis will allow for that. So I solder all the wires to the board, get the board in place, solder everything else together. Nice clean look. This board, however, doesn't really require that. So, overview of the components. We have our KR Sabers Goth 3 Designs PIY print-it-yourself chassis for a removable 18650 battery. There's the holder for the battery. Now, when you get these batteries, or these battery holders, you'll have to sand down, the little nubs right there. You'll also have to sand down the corners, most likely, and it'll fit right in. And we'll also be using a little bit of E6000 to keep it secure. E6000 takes a little longer to cure, but I recommend it over anything else personally. I use it for a ton of stuff. I rarely ever use super glue. Cannot recommend that enough. If I need something a little stronger than that, I'll go with this, Gorilla Glue Epoxy. I always try to avoid super glue. I honestly use hot glue more than super glue because sometimes I have a use for it, particularly in building a NeoPixel blade. I might do another video building a NeoPixel blade, but it's going to be a little more complex because it takes up a lot more room. This, I can just set up my camera and get it going. So, back to the parts overview. I have a 28mm KR Sabers bass speaker. It sinks in really well. Have our 18650 battery. So I went with the 3500 milliamp battery because it still pumps out 10 amps, which will be enough to drive a fully lit NeoPixel blade, even with it as white, which will draw the most amperage, which is around 9.9 amps. Also have the momentary switch, all metal. I was gonna go black because it's a black hilt, but most black switches you get are not metal. They're a cheap plastic, so I don't like them. So I'm going with this. I have a 3D printed bezel on here, which will allow it to sit flush against the circular part of the hilt. Also have a 12mm panel mount recharge port for 2.1mm chargers with a bezel. Have our high amp kill switch, which goes right in there. Also have our NeoPixel module, which is... I'll also do an overview of the tools that I use most often. You don't have to use this particular NeoPixel module. This is just the one that I had on hand. I'm currently out of 1-inch Delrin modules, but I did have this. This is a little more robust, you know, metal housing. You got your two little nubs right there. You can just screw it right on. You can either use... You can either use these, which are really useful for C-clips in like MHS hilts, Ultra Sabers hilts, so on and so forth. Or for this, I just use these tweezers. I got these at Menards. They're really good, about $5. I actually have two pairs because I like them so much. And the NeoPixel module just has that little top Delrin piece, and the module just sinks right on there. Now for this module, you will not need a 0603 SMD resistor. That will be put inside the blade. And of course we have our Verso. Very nice board. I really like it. Now for the tools, we got a lot of tools. A man is only as useful as the tools he has and knows how to use. Something I've been saying for a little while now. Now, the solder I use is Alpha Fry. You don't have to get the exact same solder I use. It's just as an example to show you what I use. I use 60-40. That's, what, 10 to lead ratio or something. It does have a rosin or a flux core. But I personally like to, as some people would say, flux it up. I get extra flux. Just get a little toothpick. Put it on there. It seems to help it flow a lot better. And then for cleanup of the flux, because you don't want to leave flux on there. I've seen some people's work, and it really bothers me seeing the amount of flux left on PCBs. For cleanup, I use a half and half mix of nail polish remover and rubbing alcohol. 90% rubbing alcohol. What I use to apply it, Q-tips. Actually, I got a Q-tip sitting out here. Also have a pair of wire strippers, go down to 32 gauge and up to 22. So 22 is the smallest, or the biggest wire I ever use, and it's still pretty darn small. But whenever you're dealing with lightsabers, all the room is what you need. You need all the room in the world. Have a little bit of heat shrink here. I believe this is 2 millimeter diameter. That's really useful for a lot of things. Have my hex wrench 564 for the set screws on here, the 832 set screws. Wire snips, really useful for tight spaces. Needle nose pliers, also really useful for tight spaces. And in case you need to do some cleanup, here we have some solder flux. And last but not least, you will need wire. So, I haven't even really thought about what wire I'm going to use yet. I know that I'll be using, I'm probably going to go 22 gauge, because that will, a single 22 gauge wire will handle, what is it, 10 to 15 amps? I think it'll handle up to 15. I can't remember. Don't quote me on that. I'll probably be using 22 gauge red, if I can hold on to it, for the positive, 22 gauge black for the negative, for the NeoPixel module. And I'll probably use 28 gauge of something for the data line. This will be specifically for the NeoPixel module. And for the switches, I'll probably use, oh, let's see, what do I got over here? I'll probably use white 28 gauge for the switch. And since I'm out of green, I'll probably use yellow 28 gauge for the switch. And also, I'll also be using 22 gauge for the recharge port as well, because it's all part of the power wiring. You got to make sure you have the same wiring through and through for the power wiring. What I mean by power wiring is anything that delivers current, as in this is power wiring, this is power wiring, this is power wiring, and this is also power wiring. What is not power wiring is the speaker and the switch. I would technically call that output or control wiring. So it's outputting a signal to the speaker, and this is controlling the board, essentially. So, I guess without further ado, we'll get started. Now that I've talked your head off, I don't think there's anything else that I can tell you without starting. I will be using a 22 gauge wire from the positive and negative and data, and I will be bridging these three pads for the LEDs. Now, one tip I can give you right off the bat is I prefer to solder to the side that says Verso, because I've already installed one of these, and I did a Tri-Cree LED. Well, I soldered to this side, and I think that it actually bridged in between the solder pad and those little bitty, teeny, tiny, itsy-bitsy pins right there. Because whenever I'd go to remove the kill key, the green LED would flicker. So I'm thinking that bridged it. Now with a NeoPixel module, you might not have to worry about that unless they have onboard LEDs similar to a stock PCB. Might have to worry about it there, but, well, it's not going to be getting data, so... See? Already thinking. You gotta think with this type of work, because it can get real expensive real quick. I mean, this is 40, 50 bucks with shipping right here. You know? It can add up really quick, and you can lose a lot of money really fast. And I actually would like to take this out of here. Yeah. So, I've already got this soldered. As far as all the pins, you can get those pre-soldered. I usually just solder them myself unless I'm pressed for time, which that's usually not the case, because you don't want to rush this work. You really don't want to rush it. You want to take your time and make sure it's done right. Anyways, I originally cut these grooves out on this battery holder. because I thought I was going to have to run tape in through these two little grooves right here, but I tested it out with the battery in it, and it's just fine with electrical tape going all the way around the whole thing. So, without further ado, let's begin. Let me get some music started. Turn that down a little bit. This is a Galactic Empire. I really like his stuff. Like, metallic version. So, when it comes to soldering, you notice you got some gunk on here, right? Clean that off. First, you will need water. You want to soak your sponge a little bit. Get at least something on there to help get all that gunk off. You can, of course, also use one of the steel pads to help clean it off. Another tip that I've learned is to essentially do that a few times. If you haven't done it recently, it's probably a good time to do it. Just something, it's like maintenance for your soldering kit. I do recommend wearing a protective mask when dealing with solder, similar to these. I wear glasses, so I just deal with it, because my glasses start fogging up. It's kind of funny, but it's not good for detailed work like this. So anytime you're done with your soldering iron, you want to leave a little bit of solder on there. So if not, it's going to get all nasty and gunky, you know. Whenever you're done with it, leave a little bit of solder on there, turn it off. So, first things first. I'm going to get my multi-vise. This is really useful. It's a Panavise mini-vise. A very useful tool. So, I'm going to go from the components to the board. So let's get this synced up here. I'm not going to have super detailed views on most of this because I already undoled the face. I've got a lot of music lined up for this. And one funny one too if you stick around long enough. So, before you solder anything, I always find it best to just get a little bit of solder on the tip. I'm going to get rid of these old wires. I don't have any use for them. Now, you'll see the solder joints are kind of pointed. I don't want them like that. So what I'm going to do, well, I'll probably bring this up to you too. You'll definitely want some type of mini vise like this. Helping hands are also very, very helpful. I've always gotten a lot of use out of the helping hands. I've known of a few members that don't like them. I'm just kind of like, well, maybe you should try again, sure will. So I'll get a little bit of solder on the tip. Get it warm. Put a little bit more on there. It's one of those things you just got to kind of play with and get used to. So, since I used, I can see there's flux on there now. It's not a lot, but there's a little bit around the solder joints on there. So I'm going to get my Q-tip, soak a little bit of cleaning mixture in it, just clean it up. And if you have really detailed work, like you need to get in between some grooves, use a toothbrush. Works really well. You know, put some rubbing alcohol mixture on there. Brush it off. Easy as that. I always use these multiple times. Yeah. Much better. And that's how you want it. Now, if you're wondering how long to make the wires, it's an easy way to figure that out. Take the hilt. That's how long. What you want to do is, I'm still going to want the customer to be able to access the board, so I'm going to measure down to here. Make it just a tad bit longer. Snip it. There's my template. like. Let's see if this tips over at any point in time. Measure out your wires that you're using. Now, what was I going to use for data? Well, I think I'll go different. I think I'll use blue for data. I normally use that for auxiliary. I like to think white hot, blue cold. Blue cold being auxiliary. So, for data, I'm just going to use blue. Just for the heck of it. Might as well. Actually, another thing you will need is the manual for the board. That is very crucial. And actually, since the last board I did was a tri-cree, I don't know where to land the data on this. So let's pull up the manual on my phone real quick. Where's that wiring diagram for me to fix? There we are. I'll even go a step further and go to the TCSS wiring diagram. They went through the struggle to make it, so. Okay. So data is landing on the fourth pad down, which would be this one right here. If you can even see that. There's that thing that everybody always says. What is it? RTFM? Read the freaking manual, alright? Boom, in action. Been doing this for 2 years and I still gotta do it. You'll never learn everything. And you'll also want a diagram for this, too. You don't want to get your... So I know this is the positive, and I know that this is the negative for the battery. But this is the negative for the board, so that's the one that goes to the board. You don't want to mix those up. In the past, with Nano Biscotti or Prism, if you swap those up, it'll fry the audio amplifier. So I actually have a picture on my phone that shows me the wiring diagram. And I've done one of these just the other day, so it's fresh in my memory. So, back to soldering. You're not going to need much length for this. It's a really small amount. Twist it up. Dip it in flux. Get a little bit of solder on the tip. I always press it against the solder, and then as I'm soldering, I push it on there. Get a nice little solder on there. I love this song. It's so good. Then you get a little bit of solder on the tip. Then you want to heat up the parts on the PCB. Stick it on there. So, as old Rob Petcow would say, it's technically not a, I guess it would be a solder joint. It's a good joint right there. You know, it's silver, there's not a lot of exposed wire. That's one thing I see a lot of people mess up on, is a lot of exposed wire. Actually, I'm going to move this down. I'm going to need my hot glue gun here soon. Are you still filming? Yep, 24 minutes in. So now I'm going to do the data, negative. What I'm going to want the hot glue for is after I get that mounted in here, I will use hot glue on the bottom side of it to secure it from any rattling, damage, anything of that sort. So if somebody wants to deal with this, should be able to get away with it. I'm going to do the data next. Since I'm right-handed, I'm going to go from the left side of the board facing me to the right. This makes it easier. It's one of those little bitty things that you don't think about. Get the wire soldered up. It's too long. No, no, it's a good one. Now, a lot of people will solder through-hole. I prefer to do it the Rob Petcow way. soldering it round down. So to explain what I'm talking about, I'll show you. Well, you'll see there's a hole on there. You can put it through the hole, or you can lay it over the top like I'm doing. Either way works. There's more than one way to skin a dog or a cat. Sorry, I'm a cat person. I'm not sorry. I love being a cat person. And you can pick your poison on that one. A lot of people like putting it through the hole. Giggity. And a lot of people like...